stop somebody else from having their moment. You can only focus on your own moment.
So the swim off. Now, what times did they swim again? We'll sort that out in a moment. So it was 67.48. Let's see. What do you think? Do you think they'll be able to match that again? I mean, the adrenaline is a different rush here, isn't it?
It is. It is a different rush.
It's quite intimidating in a way, isn't it, to come out just... It's a bit more like a boxing match, isn't it? Just one-on-one.
Or a training swim. You know, we do a lot of efforts where you'll either do it by yourself or you'll do it against a training partner. A lot riding on the line here to try and make it through to the final. The timing device does go down to the thousandth of a second, but we don't use it in swimming. It's only to the hundredth.
Terra Canadian. Terra Van Beelen here.
Nalia Atkinson from Jamaica.
And I'm just wondering, trying to ask myself a question off the top, how many Jamaicans have made finals in swimming at the World... Well, the Olympic Games.
There was Janelle Atkinson, I think, back in 1996 that made the 50 freestyle final, I believe.
Well, there's my answer. But there wouldn't be many, would there?
No. No. If you went across to track and field, it would be a different story.
So Atkinson, 23 years of age, goes to the University of Texas A&M. In the United States, and Van Beelen, 19 years of age. And their personal best is so close, 67.39 for Atkinson and 67.37 for Van Beelen.
Well, focus of the girls, have they recovered enough? Who's done the most work?
So here's a swim off between Ali Atkinson of Jamaica and Terra Van Beelen of Canada to find their way into the final of the women's 100 breast. Atkinson's been very quick out in both the heat and the semi. There's no surprise she's the early leader.
Well, she was in the semi-final as well, but Van Beelen won the 200 metres breaststroke at the Canadian trials, so expect to see her come home quite well.
So Atkinson with the lead early. The time they posted in the semi was 67.48. That's actually irrelevant here. It's just who can get to the wall first. The margin is 7/10 of a second at halfway. It's a pretty good lead.
It is a big lead, a much bigger lead than they had in the semi-final. So Atkinson really dominating here. I don't know if Van Beelen can get her from this stage.
Well, it's about a body length at the moment, and we're halfway through the second 50. So Atkinson will get through surely. So Jamaica do get that finalist in the 100 breaststroke. Interesting to see the time. It was 67.48. Now her personal best is 67.3. And this looks like it's going to be a bit quicker than that, I think. I reckon it might be 66 something. It is. That's a terrific time to back up and get a 66. So what quality there from Atkinson. And what a celebration.
That's brilliant. Well, personal best time for her. And that time of 106.79 would have placed her in fifth place.
But I guess automatically
final.
She goes into lane 8.
Yes, she does go into lane number 8. Hopefully she can repeat the performance in the final. That would be great to see. Well done to Tara as well, finishing 9th in the 100 metres breaststroke at the Olympics.
So here's the result of the swim-off in the 100 breaststroke, a personal best. And a Jamaican record, I'm sure,
yes,
for Alia Atkinson of 66.79 seconds. So she goes into lane 8 in the final, which will be staged tomorrow night. So here is the final, and Milutite, well, remarkable. She has taken the world by storm here and probably starts a narrow favourite against Sony. I think that's fair to say.
Yeah, especially given that she'd backed up that heat, so she's not proving that it was a fluke. She's proving that she's a quality act.